Rabbits, it's Trixie, and Einstein once said that two things are infinite: the universe and human stupidity. There will always be people that say the dumbest things, and they are spread all over the world. Even in Germany, we have some black sheep. People that don't watch Don't Trust the Rabbit videos. Can you imagine that? They don't want to broaden their horizon with my amazing professional German lessons and at the same time experience a new level of clever, high-quality humor. You have a movie cushion under your seat. I believe it's fair to say that somebody who deliberately chooses to miss out on my awesome content is out of their mind. I can imagine that's the same kind of people that say,
I don't get it. I mean, like, Lance Armstrong, like, walked on the moon already and stuff, right? But why is no one, like, ever talking about, like, sending people to the sun? I know it's hot and stuff, but duh, cannot they send them, like, at night or, like, in winter?
And what do you call statements like that in your head when you hear them? Exactly! Bullshit! Or, to keep it a bit more child-friendly, complete nonsense. And wow! I don't actually know why I made this sound and what it means, but that's what today's video is gonna be about. Nonsense.
Couldn't you say that about every single Don't Trust the Rabbit episode? What's so different about this one?
No. I don't mean I'm gonna talk nonsense. I don't want to steal your job. I'm gonna teach the rabbits German words for nonsense. Funny expressions Germans use that mean nonsense. It may be something that somebody says or something that somebody does. It's either nonsense, bullshit, or something along the lines of shenanigans. First of all, funnily enough, you can also say der Nonsens in German. It sounds a bit more like nonsense, though. The E in the end is dropped when you spell it. Wolfgang, Marmorkuchen ist doch nicht wirklich aus Stein, jetzt rede doch nicht so einen Nonsens. Apart from that, some other words are der Blödsinn, der Schwachsinn, or der Unsinn. As you may have noticed, all of them contain the word der Sinn, which means the sense in German. Der Blödsinn literally translates to the stupid sense. Der Schwachsinn would be the weak sense. And der Unsinn means something like the unsense or the anti-sense. So even describing senseless things, the German language makes a lot of sense.
So ein Unsinn, Wolfgang! Alle Kühe geben Milch, die Braunen geben keinen Kakao.
But of course we also have some other very funny expressions, my favorite being der Quatsch.
Quatsch, Quatsch,
Quatsch, Quatsch, Quatsch. It sounds like a purple cow stumbling and falling into a pot full of spicy mousse au chocolat that tastes like dolphins.
What?
See? That's obviously Quatsch! And if Quatsch doesn't sound silly enough, you can make it even more gorgeous by adding mit Soße. With sauce.
Das ist doch Quatsch mit Soße!
As if it's a delicious poppycock dessert covered in Jabberwocky syrup. Yummy.
Ach Wolfgang, Quatsch mit Soße. Du dachtest, weil ein Pferd Pferd heißt, fährt es dich zum Bahnhof, jetzt befrei bitte den Gaul aus unserem Auto.
Talking about food, there are two more ways to say nonsense or shenanigans in German that have to do with food. I kid you not, you can say Quark, curd, or Käse, cheese.
Der Mond ist aus Käse? Wer hat dir denn den Käse erzählt? Wolfgang!
Now considering that people saying or doing stupid things can sometimes be so annoying that it hurts, I understand that you may want to react a bit more harshly than by just naming dairy products. Luckily, there are many other and more aggressive ways to say bullshit. One option is an almost literal translation of bullshit, actually. It's der Bockmist, which is something like Buck, Ram, or Goat Poop.
Wolfgang! Du hast versucht, aus Glühbirnen und Pferdeäpfeln einen Obstsalat zu machen? Wie fällt dir bloß immer so ein Bockmist ein?
And yet another poop-related thing. Gequillte Scheiße. Literally meaning whisked shit. So, conclusion, German words for nonsense are either food or shit, I guess. James Bond likes his whiskey stirred, not shaken. Germans like their hogwash whisked. That begs for a tongue twister, doesn't it? James Whiskey versus German Whisk Hogwash. James Whiskey versus German Whisk Hogwash. German Whiskey would... James Whiskey versus German Whisk Hogwash. James Whiskey versus German Whisk Hogwash. That sounds like a lot of wishy-washy, which describes silly talks or an indecisive person in German. And I think you can say wishy-washy in English too, right? Wishy-washy is one of those words, well, words that you use from time to time without really thinking about their roots. They just sound funny and odd. And guess what? The same thing applies to five more words that mean the nonsense in German. So it's basically nonsense words describing nonsense. However, by presenting them to you, I'm gonna try and give them some sense. Not only will I name them, I'm also gonna tell you what I know about their origins. The first one is der Mumpitz. What sounds like a spitz suffering from mumps, it's actually an old German word for ghost or a demon-like figure, or a scarecrow. The word was later used on the stock market, slowly changing its meaning to lies or gossip, and eventually to the nonsense. Was meinst du mit, du konntest den Goldfisch gerade noch retten, er wäre fast ertrunken? Wolfgang, das ist Mumpitz! Fische leben doch im Wasser! Then there is der Humbug. If you are a native English speaker, then you may know it, because German basically borrowed it from English. Unfortunately, a part of some unproven suggestions, one of them being that it's connected to the city of Hamburg. Hamburg, I miss you! The origin is pretty much unknown. But to make up for that, here's a fun fact for Germans. Humbugs are actually a brand of candy, for example in the UK, and they taste like peppermint. Didn't know that before. Next up, a word that sounds like a pigeon in agony. Der Kokolores. Kokolores. Again, there is uncertainty about this word's origin, but supposedly it's related to the German word der Gaukler, the imposter. Tricks and cheating, shenanigans. Same story.
Kokolores, Wolfgang, Kokolores. Ja, ich habe mir Blumen zum Valentinstag gewünscht, aber die Gürtelrose auf deinem Bauch meinte ich damit sicher nicht.
Another odd-sounding word is Schmoo. It's like you want to say schönen guten Abend, but then you suddenly remember that you are actually a cow.
Schmoo.
Der Schmoo.
It's not a true Don't Trust the Rabbit video if you can't make at least one animal noise, right?
Yep. So come on, which one is your favorite animal? Which animal do you want me to imitate?
That would be a snail.
But snails don't say anything. They barely move. No facial expressions.
Exactly.
Schmoo is related to schmooze, which means that you talk way too much and or simply rubbish. Ganz zum Schluss, I want to mention Stuss. Stuss comes from the Western Yiddish Stuss, which means stupid stuff or even insanity.
Wolfgang, Wolfgang! Du wolltest später noch einen Tee trinken und hast deshalb heißes Wasser eingefroren. Warum redest du immer so einen Stuss? Du bist so dumm! So, Gudrun, jetzt reicht es aber. Ich habe die Nase voll, mich von dir immer so anfahren zu lassen. So bin ich eben. Ich mache viel Blödsinn, ich rede manchmal ziemliches Blech. Aber weißt du was? Du bist auch nicht perfekt. Besonders diese furchtbar hässlichen Porzellanpuppen. Die Duftkerzen, die du überall aufstellst, machen mir Kopfschmerzen. Und deine Bauchwegschlüpfer sind abtörnender, als dein Bauch jemals sein könnte. Entweder wir akzeptieren uns beide gegenseitig und behandeln einander mit Respekt, oder wir müssen nach 24 Jahren, 3 Monaten und 14 Tagen Ehe getrennter Wege gehen. Es tut mir leid, Wolfgang, es ist wohl einfach so mit mir durchgegangen. Ich liebe dich. Ich liebe dich auch, Gudrun. Komm, lass uns nach Hause gehen. Okay.
Alright, Babbitts, tell me, which of these words was your personal favorite? Obviously, there are way more German words for nonsense out there, so feel free to share them in the comments. Share everything that's on your mind. I really hope that you enjoyed today's video, that you were happy to meet Gudrun and Wolfgang. If so, please leave a thumbs up, because that would make me really, really happy. If you want more Don't Trust the Rabbit shenanigans, then feel free to follow me on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook, and here is another video you should definitely check out. Subscribe to Don't Trust the Rabbit for more videos like this one, and if you want to support my channel even a bit more, then you can also find me on Patreon. I would really appreciate your help. I wish you all a wonderful day, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye!